With a $300 to $400 million budget hole looming, the governor is now ordering state departments to cut spending in a major way. And topping our Project Economy coverage now, a closer look at the big shortfall. The governor is curtailing spending by $63 million to help balance the two-year budget, which is estimated to be short $400 million through the 2011 fiscal year. The parts of government facing the stiffest cuts are education and health and human services funding. News 8's Keith Baldi live at East End School tonight with details on the governor's plan. Good evening, Keith.
Good evening, Tori. School systems throughout the state will need to cut $38 million from their budgets. Here in Portland, more than $2.5 million. This is just the latest move by lawmakers to try and deal with this financial crisis.
On a rainy day in Augusta, the storm clouds gathered over the governor's office as he announced yet again that the state would need to make budget cuts because revenues are lower than estimated and future estimates are still worse.
It isn't pretty, but it's necessary.
Signing an executive order, the governor has initiated $63 million in cuts as a step towards balancing the budget.
A curtailment order is a blunt instrument that allows me to cut spending immediately when revenues fall. I don't take the order lightly, and I've considered its implications thoroughly. But we must continue to cut state spending. There is no option.
Departments across state government will be forced to scale back, with schools and the Department of Health and Human Services accounting for 50 of the $63 million in cuts. DHHS Commissioner Brenda Harvey says some services and programs will be affected, but they're asking the organizations that provide Mainers with assistance to try and minimize the impact.
And our hope is that all of the organizations with whom we have a contract will stretch those resources so that they can continue to serve our clients, but perhaps to do so with a little less intensity.
Meaning fewer services and hours, something that's really not feasible for school districts. The education commissioner says when it comes to cuts, schools will likely look to save on maintenance and building operations, delay purchasing, and some may institute a regional transportation plan using special computer software to create more efficient bus routes. The cuts to state government in general will not stop here, though, as Maine faces an estimated $400 million shortfall through fiscal year 2011, and that will mean tough choices for the legislature.
Games and trickery will probably not work anymore. And we're going to have to look at hard cuts and programs that we don't want to lose.
The governor's curtailment order is only a temporary thing. Eventually, the full legislature will need to come up with a supplemental budget to deal with this shortfall. We're live in Portland. Keith Baldi, News 8.